There are certain types of thinkers who are naturally drawn to the play of stressful events over and over again, thinking about what happened, what they could have or should have done differently, how the details of what occurred will affect the rest of their lives, and so on. Creative thinkers tend to fall into the latter group, replaying events over and over again to better understand them. Rumination is one of the major keys of thinking like a creative genius. To be creative is to make sense of and connect the small details of everything we experience, the good and the bad. So it only makes sense that all of that thinking would lead to manic episodes of feeling hopeless, alone, or like a failure. BBC World News have decided to team up with university art departments across the country by giving the students a camera and asking them to document their lessons. This is Reading Story. It's lesson time, and some of the students are given presentations about artists they were assigned to research by the teachers.
Oh no, I'm filming the class, so I can get like these like fillers for the documentary. So when there's like when there's like narration going on, I'll just put these bits in.
Nothing usually happens, and it's all a bit boring, but I guess it's important.
She looks at quite organic and abstract shapes, and she started off using, when she did start doing sculpture, it was sort of wood, and then she moved on to rubber, bronze and stone.
Artists Eugène Delacroix and Henri Matisse, which were 19th century French artists that depicted Middle East like scenery in their paintings.
So, how is art for you?
I think art is quite stressful sometimes because we have like essays, and they're like 500 word essays, and they take me ages, especially the references and everything like that.
Well, some people say that's kind of easy. Like, wouldn't you agree?
Yeah, but for me, I find that difficult because for art, it's different. Like, you have to explain.